hope you've been reading The Lemonade War. We hope you had a great spring break. Remember, your sister read chapter 4 over spring break. So today, we are going to act out chapter 5 for you. When we act out today, I am going to be Jessie again.
I'm Evan.
I'm the narrator.
And Mom.
Okay, so we hope you enjoy chapter 5. It's one of the most exciting chapters in the book, I think. So we're going to get ready to get started.
Rivalry in the marketplace. Dinner that night at the Treskys was quiet, so the explosion that followed seemed especially loud. It was Jessie's turn to clear and scrape the dishes, Evan's turn to wash and stack. Evan looked at the pile at the dirty plates on his left. Jessie was ahead. She was always ahead when it was her turn to clear, but tonight it felt like she was taunting him. To Evan, every plate scraping sounded like, "Can't keep up, can't keep up!" Evan was scrubbing the casserole pan when Jessie stacked the last dirty dish by his elbow. Then she stuck her hands under the faucet to rinse without even saying, "Excuse me," and shook her hands practically right in Evan's face and said,
"So how much money did you make?"
That was it. He couldn't hold it in any longer.
"Why'd you do it, huh? Why'd you have to ruin the one thing I had going on?"
For a second, Evan wasn't sure if he meant the lemonade stand or Megan Moriarty. In a mixed-up way, he meant both. And there was no way he was going to tell Jessie that after paying back his mother for 4 cans of lemonade, 1 can of grape juice, and 1 bottle of ginger ale, she'd been pretty irritated when she came down from the office and there wasn't a single cold drink in the house. He had walked away with $2.11. On top of that, he was pretty sure Scott kept the $5 bill that they'd earned. Well, what was Evan supposed to do? Ask Scott to turn his pockets inside out? Evan hadn't kept track of the sales, so he couldn't be sure.
"Why'd I do it? Why'd you do it? Why did you invite that meanie over for a lemonade stand? And how come you couldn't let me play? You're the one who was being mean."
"You're such a show-off. Let everyone know that you're the smart one."
"I wasn't showing off. I was trying to have a little fun. Is that against the law? You won't do a lemonade stand with me, so I won't do a lemonade stand with you. I'll do one with Megan instead."
"You cannot not be her friend. You cannot not be her friend."
"Why?"
"Because you're a little kid. You don't even belong in the fourth grade. And because you're just annoying and you show off and no one likes you."
The words felt like disgusting spiders running out of his mouth. They were horrible, but it felt so good to get rid of them. Then Evan saw Jessie's lip tremble. Uh-oh. Jessie was a howler. She didn't cry often and she didn't cry long, but when she did, it was loud. Mom would come down from her office. Evan would catch the blame.
"So unfair!"
But Jessie didn't let loose. Instead, she stood as tall as her runty height would allow and said,
"Megan likes me. She invited me over to her house tomorrow. We're going to make a lemonade stand and earn twice what we did today."
Oh, that was it. She was going to ruin everything. Show him up right in front of Megan. Even before the school year started. Make Megan think he was just a nobody who couldn't even beat out his baby sister at a lemonade stand. Evan boiled over.
"I wouldn't count on it, Juicy."
Jessie hated that nickname, and Evan only used it when he had to.
"I'm going to have a lemonade stand every day until school starts. And after that, I'm going to earn $100 by myself, and I'm going to buy an iPod."
"Oh, please. Like you could even if you wanted to. Megan and I already made $12 today. We could have $100 like that."
"And then what? What are you going to do with it? Put it in your lockbox? And save it until you're 50 years old? You're such an old miser."
Jessie stiffened up. Her mouth made a funny O shape. But then she put her hand on her hip and smirked at Evan.
"For your information, I'm going to make a $100 donation to a charity."
"What charity?
call me a miser again.
I hope I never have to talk to you again.
Hey. Mrs. Tresky had a pencil stuck in her hair and a worried look on her face.
What is going on down here? I am in the attic trying to work. The air conditioning's even on, guys, and I still hear you. What's up?
Evan looked at Jesse. Jesse looked at Evan. They had taken a vow, a split vow. Ever since Dad had gone, they had vowed not to fight in front of Mom. It made her sad. Sadder, even, than when Dad left.
Nothing. Nothing.
Come out with it. What is it?
It wasn't a fight. It was just joking around.
Yeah, we were just goofing. Sorry we got you out of your office.
Mrs. Tresky looked at both of them with her laser eyes. Jesse hung the dish towel on the oven handle and fiddled with it until it was perfectly straight. Evan bent over the casserole pan and scrubbed it as if his life depended on it. He scrubbed so hard, his elbow bumped the fruit bowl. A cloud of fruit flies rose into the air and then settled back down.
Oh, goodness. Would you look at those fruit flies? All right, guys. I'm going back upstairs for a little while. You need to go ahead and get your teeth brushed. You need to get yourself a bath and get ready. Can you guys handle this?
Sure, Mom.
No problem.
Mrs. Tresky disappeared upstairs. Jesse turned to Evan at the sink.
Let's make a bet. Whoever earns $100 wins, and the loser has to give all the earnings to the winner.
Not fair. You already have money saved up.
That money doesn't count. We'll start with what we earned today, and it's all going to be from selling lemonade. No mowing lawns or any of that.
Well, what if neither one of us makes $100?
Then whoever gets the closest to $100 wins. And even if we make over $100, whoever makes the most money wins.
When are we going to count the money?
Sunday night, right before the fireworks. Huh? What do you say?
Evan didn't like bets. He really wasn't that into competition. He loved to play baseball and always gave it his all. But winning or losing just didn't make much of a difference to him. He just liked to play. But this was different. This mattered. If he didn't beat Jesse at this bet, if he couldn't win against his little sister in a lemonade war, then Evan thought of the school year stretching in front of him. It was all over. He might as well just give up on everything right now.
It's a bet. Winner takes all. We'll count the money on Saturday.
He shook his wet hands over the sink, dried them on the dish towel, and gave Jesse the most menacing.